One of the first algorithms that you may learn about is how to merge two sorted lists. We put a pointer at the beginning of each list and we keep taking the smallest element and increasing the pointer until we finish them both. This is what we call two-way merge. But what if we want to merge k-sorted lists, not only two? We can think of using the same logic as for merging two sorted lists. We put a pointer at the beginning of each list, it represents the next element to be taken. Then at each iteration, we search for the list that has the smallest next element, we take it, and we increment the pointer. This is what we got with this example. In code, k represents the number of lists, and represents the total number of elements that we can get by calculating the sum of lengths. Then, we create an array output where will be our final sorted list. Add an array pos that contains the position of the next element to be taken of each list. They all start at 0. The final list will contain n elements, so while output has less than n elements, we'll start by calculating the index of the list from where we will take our next element. To do so, we take the min among the k indexes, where for the list at index I, the comparison key is its next element to be taken, lists of I, pos of I, if we didn't reach its end obviously. Because if we did, we can't take elements from it anymore, so we put infinity, to be sure that it won't be selected as the minimum. Now that we got the index of the list from where we will take the next element, we append its next element to the output, and we increment. We increment position of list index. After the loop, we return the sorted final list. For the time complexity, we're inserting an element at each iteration, so we have n iterations. And to get the next element, we're traversing all the k indexes to find the minimum, so an iteration costs k. We get an of n times k time complexity. This one is not the only solution. We can also, for example, just concatenate the list together and solve the result. We get an of n log n time complexity because we're sorting n elements. We still have all the solutions. We know that merging two sorted lists produces a sorted list. And we know how to merge two sorted lists with two-way merge. So in our list of lists, we can merge the first one with the second one, we merge that produced list with the third one, we merge that produced list with the fourth one, and so on until the end. We will have merged all of them into a sorted list. In code, we first need a function that merges two sorted lists. We create an array output. We put two pointers I and j at the beginning of L1 and L2 respectively. Then while both of them still have elements, if R1 of I is smaller than R2 of J, then we take R1 of I and we increment I. Else, we take R2 of J and we increment J. After the loop, to take remaining elements of the list we didn't end yet, we add the part of R1 that starts from I and the part of R2 that starts from J, and we return the output. Now in Kway, we start with an empty list, then for each list, output becomes the result of merging output with the list. It's like output keeps eating lists until it eats them all. After the loop, we return output. For the time complexity, we're traversing the k lists, so we have k iterations for the loop. And each iteration costs O of n because we merge at most n elements. We get an O of n times k time complexity. We can improve it by merging the first one with the second one, the third one with the fourth one, and so on. We keep doing that until we merge the last two lists. In code, while we have more than one list, we traverse even indexes and we replace lists of I by the result of merging lists of I with lists of I plus 1. At the end of an iteration of the outer loop, we remove those in odd indexes. We keep new ones only, those in even indexes. We keep doing that until one list remains, we return it. For the time complexity, we have k lists and we're dividing the number of lists by 2 at each iteration, so we have log 2 of k iterations for the outer loop. And the cost of one iteration is n, because we're traversing all the n elements. We get a time complexity of O of n log k. Another solution? Yes, we have. We want to merge k lists. What if we merge the first k by 2 list into one sorted list, merge the last k by 2 list into one sorted list, and we apply two-way merge to merge them. And to merge k divided by 2 lists, we'll merge the first k divided by 4 lists together, the last k divided by 4 lists together, and we apply two-way merge. Basically, it will be a recursive process. Here is a small example. In code, if we have only one list, we directly return it. Else, we calculate the mid index, we recursively merge the part that ends at mid, we recursively merge the part that starts from mid, and we apply two-way merge on the results. For the time complexity, we're calling the recursive function twice with k divided by two lists, and we have the cost of splitting and merging, 2n, let's say n. We get t of nk is equal to 2 times t of n divided by 2 k divided by 2 plus n. We also know that when k is equal to 1, when we have only one list, we just return it, the cost is O of 1. We replace t of n divided by 2 k divided by 2 is 2 times t of n divided by 4 k divided by 4 plus n divided by 2. By simplifying, we get 4 times t of n divided by 4 k divided by 4 plus 2n. We replace again, t of n divided by 4 k divided by 4 is 2 times t of n divided by 8 k divided by 8 plus n divided by 4. By simplifying, we get 8 times t of n divided by 8 k divided by 8 plus 3n. From here, we can deduce a general expression. We have t of nk is equal to 2 power I times t of n divided by 2 power I k divided by 2 power I plus I times n. We already have the value of t when k is equal to 1, so we search for the value of I to reach 1. It's log 2 of k, because k divided by 2 power log 2 of k is 1. We replace I by log 2 of k, we get t of nk is equal to 2 power log 2 of k times t of n divided by 2 power log 2 of k, k divided by 2 power log 2 of k, plus log 2 of k times n, which is k times t of n divided by k 1 plus log 2 of k times n, because 2 power log 2 of a is a. We know that when k is 1, t is O of 1, so t of nk is equal to k plus log 2 of k times n, which gives an O of n log k time complexity. We still have a solution to discover. In a previous solution, at each iteration, we were traversing the k list to find the minimum, which resulted in an O of n times k in time complexity, too slow. But what if we can't find the minimum in less than O of k? We can do so by using a priority queue. If you don't know what is a priority queue, I suggest you to watch this previous video I made. The priority queue, when implemented with a heap, gives us the ability to insert and extract min in O of log n time, where n is the number of elements in it. And in our problem, we will use a priority queue that initially contains k elements, the first element of each list. Then at each iteration, we extract the min from it, we add it to our output array, and if the list from where we took the element still has elements, we insert its next element in the queue for the next iterations. In code, we will use the heap queue module to avoid implementing a priority queue from scratch. And because heap queue doesn't give the possibility to set a comparison key, we will put in a tuples where the first element is the value that will determine the order. In our case, is the value of the element in the list. Tuples of our priority queue will contain three elements: the value of the element, its position in the list, and the position of the list it belongs to. Let me show you an example to understand. We start from the beginning for each list, so here are our initial elements in the queue. We have 5, the first element of the list 0, 6, the first element of the list 1, 1, the first element of the list 2, and so on. We said that we compare these tuples according to their first element, so the smallest one here is 1. We add it to our output. We took the element 0 from the list 2, so the next element that we take from there is the one at index 1. In the queue we insert 8, 1, 2. It means 8, the element 1 of the list 2. Next iteration, the smallest one is 5. We add it to our output. Its index was 0, we increment it, and we insert in the queue 8, 1, 0. Next iteration, the smallest one is 6, we add it to our output. Its index was 0, incremented, and we insert in the queue 7, 1, 1. And so on until the queue becomes empty. The queue becomes empty at some point because we don't always reinsert an element. When we increment the index and we see that it reached the end of its list, we have nothing to insert. We move to the code. At the beginning, we insert list of 0, 0, I for each list I, because we take the element at index 0 whose the value is list of 0. We heapify to convert it to a heap, and we start. While the output has less than n elements, we extract min from the queue, we get a tuple of 3 elements that we put in 3 variables, lm, lmindex, and listindex. We insert lm in the output, we increment lm index, and if it's still smaller than the length of the list index, it means that we still have elements in it. We insert list of list index lm index, lm index, list index. We're inserting the element at index lm index of the list list index, whose the value is list of list index lm index. After the loop, we return the output. For the time complexity, we have n iterations for the loop, but this time an iteration cuts off log k only, because our queue has at most k elements, one for each list, so inserting and extracting min cuts off log k. We get a time complexity of O of n log k. We've seen a total of 6 solutions. We obviously take the O of n log k solutions because k is usually way smaller than n. And between the 3 O of n log k solutions, after trying with different inputs, I noticed that the priority q1 is faster. We reached the end of this video. In this one, we've seen k-way merge algorithms. I wanted to do this video because it's interesting to see how the same problem can be solved with a lot of different ways. If you enjoyed, like, subscribe, and share the video. And see you in the next one.